Hello children, welcome back to your social studies class. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is Maps Are Guides. So be ready for your class. Children, as we learnt in previous chapter that a globe is a small model of the earth. It shows us correct shape and the location of the continents, oceans, different countries on a smaller scale. Details like states, cities, towns of a country cannot be shown on a globe. However, it has certain limitations. First, only half the globe is visible at a time. Second, it cannot give correct idea of the distances between two places. Third, it cannot give details about a small area. Fourth, we cannot figure out the type of terrain and landscape of a place on the globe. Children, you can see this moving globe. Can you find a particular place on it? No, right? So, to overcome from the limitations of the globe, we generally use maps. Now let's see what is a map. A map is a drawing of the earth or a part of it on a flat surface. Students, please remember, a person who makes map is called a cartographer, and the study of maps is called cartography. Now, advantages of maps. It gives more specific and detailed information about a small area. It can be folded or rolled and carried anywhere. It can be drawn to show the entire earth, a continent, a country or a state. Now, types of maps. There are basically three types of maps: political maps, physical maps and thematic maps. Maps can be of the world or a country. First, political maps. Political maps are the maps showing the boundaries of different countries, states, cities, major highways, etc. as defined by humans. Second, physical maps. These maps show the physical features of a place in the world. They generally show things like rivers, mountains, plains, hills, etc. You can see in this map, different colors are used to indicate different physical features. Like blue color indicates water bodies, brown color indicates mountains, green color indicates plains, etc. Third, thematic maps. These maps focus on particular theme or specified topic like climate, vegetation, soil, rainfall, etc. Children, now tell me, when many maps are put together in the form of a book, what it is called? Yes, the book which contains different types of maps is called as an atlas, or we can say a book of maps is called an atlas. That's all for today. We will continue this chapter in our next video. Thank you.